And I'm sitting here fucking dying of laughter, though, because of the Mercedes Moné interview that we did during the pre-show with her on Hot 97. There's still a little bit more to go to, and I want to hit it before we move on to other things. So more important things. But let me go ahead and cue this up. So
this was years ago.
Yeah.
Were you saddened by it? Were you
I was so depressed by it. I feel like, when was that? In 2018 or 2017? That definitely set me on a spiral of depression because of wrestling has always been my biggest goal and dream, and I've always wanted to be the greatest at it. So to hear any kind of noise that people might not think you're safe, or it wasn't even the boys in the back, it's just the fans thinking you're not safe.
Yeah.
It's scary sometimes, but that's the business that we're in. Yeah. You never know when you're going to get hurt. You never know when you're going to.
Doesn't that feel like such a stock answer at this point? Like, I kind of hate that, because it's a way that it seems a lot of wrestlers say that in order to write off what they do. So in this scenario, obviously Hot 97 brought up, you know, like, what do you say to people that bring up that you're an unsafe wrestler, or unsafe worker? And the stock answer is, well, that's the business we're in. You know, we're in the business where accidents happen. And that's true. And that's the problem with that stock response, Joe, is it is true. But it's like, at some point, when do you take responsibility for some of the silly shit you've done?
Yeah, but dude, like, I mean, I drank 4 old fashions, all right, in an hour. And then I went out and drove.
Mm-hmm.
But accidents happen, dude. That's what happens in cars. You know what I mean?
Yeah, like, of course.
That's what it's supposed to be. Like, ooh, I'm sorry I drove through the fucking front of your goddamn store. Like, I was hungry. I had to get something to eat. I was shit-faced and I was hungry, so I had to go drive. You know what I mean? Like, what, are there other ways for food to get to me?
Yeah. No,
I had to go. Like, I mean, and accidents happen, dude. That can happen at any time in a car. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, I just hated the stock response, but she goes on a little bit further.
Sprain something, break a neck, break a knee. There's just, it's the business.
Yeah.
You have to go out there knowing that you're going to put your life on the line.
Ascension, wow.
But we do everything we can to protect each other. And unfortunately, that happened.
Like, boot them directly
in
the spine.
What's the hardest move that someone's done on you where you felt like, I felt that one.
Ooh, I've taken a couple of people's finishers from it, like, really high up. Or like, if you take something from the top rope, you'll take that impact and you're just like, oh, why did I agree to that? And oh, my back's going to feel that. Not just.
Ugh. All right. That's not.
Yeah, we get it. Right. We get it. Well, you're also 100 pounds and 5 feet tall, so you're probably not supposed to be doing any of this, but that's okay. You know what I mean?
In a different part of the interview, she also starts talking about, her contributions to wrestling as a whole, Joe.
Yeah.
In the last 2 years when I was going through leaving WWE, I'm like, should I be done with wrestling? Because this is not fun for me. Mm-hmm. All this noise is not fun. And then I was like, no, you love this. It's not the noise. It's the noise in the ring. It's the noise when you perform. It's the noise when you go out there with the crowd. Yep. It's not this internet noise. It's not the politics.
Geez,
you can work
fans.
Through that. Yeah. There's going to be politics everywhere. And it's how you work through that. And it's really how I grew from a legit boss to a CEO. I want.
Oh, no.
That's how I went from being a boss to being a CEO.
Which I want to, that's one of those moments where you're like, oh, how did that happen, dude? Like, it's like someone who's 22 years old and they own their own whatever business. And someone's like, dude, how did you, your dad gave it to you? Oh, okay. Like that. Oh man, you own your own electrical company at 23 years old? How did that happen? Someone gave it to you.
Somebody gave it to you.
Oh, that's how. I became a CEO. I upgraded from being a boss. By the way, these are not real. Not real titles.
Just, the insanity of actually trying to talk about yourself in the real world. I'm actually really a boss. Of what?
Of what?
Of being a boss. I'm the boss of bosses. Like, Triple H is the king of kings, but I'm the boss of bosses. I'm so much of a boss, I am now a CEO.
But by the way, I'm not sure if, and maybe I'm crazy here.
Yeah.
Maybe some people, this is a major aspiration in their life, but I don't associate being a CEO with being a good thing.
No, it's.
I really kind of see that.
It's the shittiest person on the corporate ladder.
Right. It's the CEO is like the person that's like, wait, what, dental plans for their families?
Right.
What do these fucking people want?
What, they you got hurt on the job? They want me to pay for this?
Like, yeah. Wait, what happened? An actual piano fell on them due to my negligence? Well, there's got to be some way to get me out of that. Like, yeah. It's like, that's the, nobody hears that and goes, oh yeah.
Retirement plan? What the fuck is that?
Wait. If these people wanted pensions, they would have joined a career that has pensions. Right. Well, they did. But, you know.
But instead, they're working here at Walmart, guys.
Yeah, no, it's not a positive thing there. Yeah.
But Mercedes, it is. It is, Joe.
I wanted to be a CEO of my own life. I wanted to take control of my life and my career. So 2 years ago, I was really questioning myself if I should still do this. And I was like, no, you're amazing.
Do it again. Question it again.
Oh, no, you missed it. You missed that part.
I'm sorry. I want her to keep questioning.
She was questioning herself. And she came up with the response.
Whole of my life and my career. So 2 years ago, I was really questioning myself if I should still do this. And I was like, no, you're amazing. And you still have so much more to give and do.
What kind of answer is that? Should I still do this? Meanwhile, fucking Sasha's laying on the ground paralyzed for 7 fucking years. No, it's not me. It is the children who are wrong. She's insane. That's the level of insane, of just lack of self-awareness on any level. Like, I
you know what's great about that? Yes. Is that somebody who was slightly less delusional, or even better at being full of shit, would have included anybody in that story.
Oh yeah.
Anybody in that story. And then, you know, I was talking to my mom. Oh, you know, I was talking to my wife, my husband, whoever, and they told me, you're too damn good to give this up. Instead, it's like, you know what? I listen to my favorite person. My own fucking self.
My multiple personalities said that I'm the greatest. She's got like Barry Horowitz syndrome. She's just patting herself on the back all the time.
Just the idea of being like... Yeah, I really doubted myself until myself came along.
Right.
And myself told myself that I'm fucking awesome. It's like,
I told myself and the rocks that I was great. I was so great.
I like the idea of
being in a room and there's just rocks laid along a windowsill.
Does she put like little faces on them? Like Toonytown Wrestling, like Marvin has puppets and shit. So when she talks to them, she can look at something.
I hope the rocks do show up on Toonytown. No, it's like Eric Cartman's fucking puppets. That are like, Eric, you are totally cool and not that.
Marvin needs a rock puppet now. An actual crystal with a face on it.
What was that?
Like Jeff Dunham.
I paid... What is that pile of salt I paid $700 for? You're totally cool. You are the best women's wrestler in the world.
He's actually got his show going on right now, too. It just started at 8 p.m. Eastern. If you haven't checked it out, he does his movie shows on Thursday nights now. So feel free to check him out before or after the show, along with John Draper and Spitball Media.
We're going to have to send him a rock, dude. We're going to have
to. Yes.
That's what we should make a team.
I'm thinking maybe this is a Patreon bit. We just start sending people rocks.
I just send them a little fuck. This might look like a rock that I picked off the beach near Boston and dusted off of an old chewed up Marby Red.
Yeah.
But it's actually healing you.
It's a healing rock, yes.
Yeah. I mean, the guy, this
makes your promos better. You'll get $8 million in your contract. It's amazing.
I like the idea of.
And only give it to wrestlers. I don't even want to give it to fans. We can only send them out to wrestlers.
Oh, no, no. I believe in, what did she say it was? Abundance or manifestation or whatever the fuck it was. Right. Just the idea, dude, that would be, oh, my God. Oh, my God almighty. I might have to get back into the wrestling business with this alone. Just to be at a show and then just hear someone cut the worst fucking promo and then go, just walk over to them and hand them a rock. Hungry?
Oh, my God.
I think that I heard that promo. Oh. Sounds like you need. You're not you without rock. You put a rock in their hand and they're like, oh, my God, I'm a good talker now. What is this? Daniel Garcia. Dude, they better start boofing Daniel Garcia with these things.
Oh, he's just going to come out there with a rock belt, an entire belt made of rocks.
They're going to find him dead with a colon full of.
The Rock, the new AEW title, the Rock title.
I listened to you. I trusted you. Oh, no, it's the ghost of Daniel Garcia, John.
Fuck King of the Ring. I want that Rock title.
Stop haunting me, Daniel Garcia. I told you the rocks would give you powers. Maybe you just don't manifest well enough.
Oh, all
right. W Rock.
Let's finish this show.
The Z
should still do this. And I was like, no, you're amazing. And you still have so much more to give and do that you can't quit on your dreams now.
What was the reasoning that you left?
There's so many reasonings.
Oh, okay.
But the biggest thing is just listening to my heart and my soul. Something didn't felt right that day. Mm-hmm. How we were talked to didn't settle in my heart. And I just instantly knew, like, if I wasn't going to take control of my life right here and now, then I was never going to be happy there by having someone talk to me the way that they do. Or
like what? Telling you to lose a match? I mean, what the fuck does this mean? I was listening to my heart and soul and they said, Vince McMahon is a bad guy and I don't want to listen to what he wants me to do.
I'm going to do that now whenever I'm just being an asshole about anything. I'm listening to my heart and soul right now. And I'm really sick of waiting in this line.
That was like a disco band in the 70s, right? Heart and soul.
So, dude, when I went to go turn in an old modem at Xfinity the other day and they made me stand in line too long, I should have been like, I'm listening to my heart and soul. And then I just throw it at the wall and leave. I'm listening to my heart and soul. I don't want to stand here anymore. And I just fucking kick it across. You do it.
Why am I getting bad internet connection? I'm listening to my heart and soul, and they say it's your fault.
Did you try unplugging your heart and soul and plugging it back in?
That you have to wait for your heart and soul to cycle. It has to cycle.
I'm only getting so many bars at my heart and soul right now. Is it because you're a cold witch?
You know, sometimes during prime time and peak hours, your heart and soul doesn't give you as much as it would during non-prime time hours.
Oh, you should try, you should sign up with T-Mobile or Mint Wireless or whoever the fuck would sponsor.
Or Skynet by Elon Musk. Yeah.
God, I don't know if Elon Musk. I don't know what Elon Musk would think about this whole promo.
About heart and soul. I have no idea. He just doesn't have enough rocks.
Feeling like you just don't belong. Like, okay, I've been doing this for 14 years and to feel like this as this low, my soul's like, you know, get up, go.
That's a big decision though.
It was.
You sure you're not schizophrenic?
I was going to say like everything has a voice and none of it is from people. Like my heart has a voice. My soul has a voice. The 100 rocks in my rooms, they all talk to me too. And listen, me, myself, and I, we all love each other.
Listen, I'm not a psychologist. I don't have a degree, but I've heard every single, 4 minutes of this?
Yeah.
At no point have I heard her say, I am taking responsibility for anything I do.
Or Joe.
It's her heart. It's her soul. It's rocks. It happens. I can't believe that someone would do this to me.
But at no
point,
Joe, but at no point, like you even brought up a couple seconds ago, there's no point where she's saying, oh, well, my mother or my dad gave me advice. At no point did my husband give me advice. You know, like at no point is there another person in this subject. This is all just the voices in her own fucking skull. Like, she's not even asking people, like, what do you think I should do? Like, I'm having a problem here in WWE. No, no. Contact your heart and soul and see what they think. Like, the fuck?
Can somebody please tell her that heart and soul is also, I don't know if it's always referred to this, but sometimes that's just called your fucking ego.
Oh, yeah, well, yeah. Yeah, your that's id, also your ego and your super ego. Everything is
yeah. super ego. Right. Well, like I said, like I don't want to stand here. I don't want to be in line at the fucking grocery store or whatever. My heart and soul is telling me to fuck these people. I'm just going to leave. It's like, yeah, no, that's your ego. It's your big fucking head that is telling you you're too good.
Why couldn't to do one of her
other
voices
people have to do?
Why couldn't one of her voices be Joe E. Numbers, huh?
Oh my god.
I listen to my heart and my soul and Joe E. Numbers.
And it's just me. It's me living in, you know what? That would be my hell as they put me in some entitled lady's fucking skull.
Your Catholic hell is being in Sasha's head.
I gotta make do. I gotta do a lot of good things. It's like, otherwise I'll be cursed to live in some rich white lady's fucking head.
Stop kicking the Roomba. Fuck. Fuck.
She's like, you know, I should probably leave my job that pays me millions of dollars because they ask me to do it. No, don't do that.
But The Rock said.
Yeah, there's, why are you listening to Rocks? Oh, this is actually amazing and frightening at the same time.
Oh yeah, that somebody that could be this rich and this powerful and this influential in wrestling and in a business that people scrounge and fight to even make a quarter of the amount of money that she's making can be this distance and detached from fucking reality.
I feel like I don't even have to say this, Mish, but I think that I can blindly endorse hallucinogens for this individual. Are you right there with me on this?
I'm with you, man. I wish
we need a dose, dude. We gotta get rocked if we're talking like this. You know what I mean?
If I was on hallucinogens, I think I would still be self-aware enough to know that I would sound like a fucking crazy person to the outside.
No. I mean, I'm saying just to shake whatever's going on in this person's head.
Oh, I thought you were saying just you had to take hallucinogens to get to this
point.
Oh, no, to
deal
with
her? Yeah, no, you're right. That too. That I just. And then me, my heart and soul and voices, and I'm just chomping away on a big fucking, like the fat kid in Charlie and the Chocolate Factory of mushroom chocolate.
A little more, guys, a little more.
It's the hardest decision. I mean, WWE was always my dream when I was 10 years old. So to be with that company for 10 years and to walk out was the hardest decision I've ever made in my whole life.
And can I say this too? And this is one thing we haven't really hit on, but even her natural tone, the way she's talking to this lady, even though she doesn't mean it, everything she says comes off as condescending. Like everything, her voice, the timbre in her voice.
I think it's the California voice.
Is that
too,
what it is? Because man, it comes off as real condescending. What do you mean California? Don't you mean Boston, Massachusetts?
What? No, we're good at sarcasm. There's a difference between that one. At least you know when we're fucking with you. You know what I mean? Like, that's the California West Coast way of doing it is like, I guess.
Right. I'm just saying the condescending voice does not make any of this sound better. It makes it so much worse. Yeah.
This girl's a trooper for interviewing her. Honest to God. Like, she really is.
But it's now the greatest decision I've ever made because where I am today, the TBS champion, the highest paid woman in women's wrestling history.
Thank you, Kev. Thank you, Tony.
Yes. Thank you, AEW.
Mm-mm, boy.
Ugh. This is where we would have to appeal to what you would know. All the women's wrestlers on the independents that have been struggling, and especially ones that have been around in the business for longer than 10 years, listening to that and then seeing the type of person that she comes off as and seeing the silly shit that comes out of her mouth, how would you guess that that makes them feel?
Well, you know what? I'm gonna go with a perfect example. And the name, I mean, sometimes like nature just like manifests perfectly for you, Mitch. Like sometimes the universe just provides. Yeah. And in this instance, it does. I have a great example of this woman. Her name was Nikki Rocks. Do you remember Nikki Rocks?
Yes, I do.
Funny enough, you know, like I said, like the universe that just provides me with
okay.
rock lore. She was a really, really good worker mm-hmm. and a fucking hell of a nice person too. Just a very talented, kind person. Do you know what happened with her? No. I don't know if you know the story. No, so no. she went to TNA.
Yeah.
Right around the time where TNA was like bordering on being Pee Wee's Playhouse. Like it was a fucking disaster.
Right.
And this was before, I'm pretty sure this was, I don't know if the Knockouts were there or whatever. But anyways, long story short, she ended up in TNA and then they put her in an angle where they shaved her head and then pretty much stopped using her like 2 months later.
Right. Not even. I thought she was kind of hot with that shaved head, honestly, but that's just me. Anyways.
I mean, she's a pretty woman.
Yeah, like, right.
You know, right? But like, well, no, that's the funny thing is like that half shaved head thing that was popular that Bailey insists on doing still. When they're like, whoa, she still looks good with it. I'm like, yeah, but they had somebody who's so good looking, you put a turd on their head. They're still
fair enough. Yeah. Looking. Okay.
You know what I mean? Yeah, like, that's not an ugly person's haircut. You know what I mean? Like, you got to already be really good looking. But no, like, that's a good example of that, where it's like, here's this woman who, like, she came in the right way. She trained with very, very reputable trainers and people and did the right shit and worked really hard. And she ended up leaving the business because she was like, yeah, fucking, what the fuck? What did I do? She ended up being a personal trainer. I haven't heard or seen from her in well over a decade now. Right. But I think about people like that who were super, super talented, very, very smart, tried to do the right thing. And I knew for a fact that a lot of them were living just like every other guy or every other wrestler, where it was just like hand to mouth, just waiting for an opportunity, doing everything they can, once again, trying to do the right thing. And then I hear a rock manifestation, private jets, creative control. They didn't sit right in my soul. They told me that I didn't want to do, like, if I was one of these women that used to be an independent wrestler or is an independent wrestler that has worked hard, tried to do the right thing, really gone out of their way to grow and be creative. And I hear this where it's just like, yeah, I'm the most paid ever. And you know, in your heart, it's not because you're the best
right.
or she's the best. You know, it's simply because she found a guy dumb enough to give it to her.
Oh, is that? Hold on, I got to put a pause on this. And Pat needs to clarify this. Did Pat just put up her Instagram or her Etsy where she's literally doing the exact same thing Sasha's talking about? She's
oh God, a I sure witch hope not.
And spiritual soul coach.
Oh my God,
that is her. Oh, a visionary soul of candlelight intentions. Oh no,
I deserve that for putting over somebody.
Joey!
Deserve, you see, folks, this is what happens when I'm nice.
And empowering women
fucking nice.
To elevate dude, life's she, magic.
Oh, man, you know what? Sasha, Mercedes, Crystal, whatever you're calling yourself this week, there's your girl.
Oh my God.
Get Nikki Rich. Help her out.
Give her the right give rocks. Yeah.
Give her your spiritual fucking blah, 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 blah money. Yeah, isn't that, once again, rocks, dude. Dude, it's like the universe provides, man.
That's so fucked up. What a random person to bring up. The voodoo queen from
I just remember, because like I said, in my head, I just remember this person.
Right.
Who was very, very talented and just, you know, wrestling in life is a lot about timing. And that's also it too. Like, and I think this is where, when I look at a lot of whatever it is, the AEW guys or even some of the WWE guys that have been goobers, where I go, how the fuck do these idiots make all this money? And then you're like, oh yeah, it's just timing.
Yeah.
it's timing, but no, like to hear her be like, and then I make the most money.
I know. Well, that's what I wanted to keep going. Let's play a little bit more about.
Can't wait
about Mercedes being humble.
Highest paid woman in women's wrestling history.
Come on. I was going to ask Kev.
Thank you, Tony. Yes. Thank you, AEW. and I can just go on and on of all these amazing opportunities that have happened since I listened to my heart and just walked out. I walked out of that door and I walked into so many more doors that were open for me. Mm-hmm. So it's a beautiful thing. When one door closes or when one door, they want to push you out of it, just know that there are so many doors, there's so many keys waiting for you to grab to go open those doors and opportunities. So you have to go out there and get it. And know it's okay to be afraid.
Yeah.
It's okay to be afraid. Right. It's okay to make mistakes because that's how you grow. That's how you learn. And these past 2 years is where I've grown the most. And it's the most fulfilling feeling in the world, knowing that I made mistakes, but how I overcome them and where I am today. Because I...
Knowing that you've made what a horse line shit of advice. Just it's okay to make mistakes as long as you don't own up to them. It's fine. It's okay.
As long as you project your guilt onto everybody else in the world.
Just tell people that you have a rock now and it'll never happen again.
Good God. God Almighty. And it's only funnier because, you know, folks, try this at home too. But once again, Mish and I, we're professionals when it comes to listening to these types of silly, stupid interviews and being able to pick them apart and whatever. But like, it doesn't even take that. It doesn't even take that level of like, let's sit here and dissect it. This is why she's getting booed in these buildings.
Right.
Because regular people, everyday folks that aren't sitting around and, you know, dissecting fucking shit on wrestling podcasts for years. They're listening to this on the fucking train, in their car, on the way to work, on wherever. And they're going, this doesn't sit right with my soul. Do you know what I mean? Like they're here.
Of course going, not. How the going, fuck is the any blue collar asshole listening to this going, oh, tell me more, Sash. Tell me more about how to be successful. Rocks. Okay, I wrote that down. Rocks. Heart. Mm-hmm. Okay, listen to my heart. Oh, and my soul. Listen to my soul. Yes, yes.
Yeah.
Oh.
Just believe everything will work out for you.
Right, right.
Of course, that's the most important part. Meanwhile, it's like 90% of the people in the country are fucked, are absolutely fucked, are so absolutely utterly like they're one illness or loss of job away from absolute fucking destitution. Right. And it's like, no, just leave your $1 million job if it doesn't fit right with your soul. Because some guy with a choo-choo train collection that idolizes Paul Heyman might show up and give you $10 bajillion.
Follow WrestleSoup on Twitter at WrestlingSoup. Like and subscribe to Wrestling Soup on YouTube. And check out the Discord for live chat during the shows at discord.gg/wrestlingsoup. Check out and subscribe to the shows on Apple, Amazon, iHeartRadio, Spotify, and more.